Well, hey there, guys. Jennifer Kilpatrick here with Coldwell Banker Apex. As I strive to continue to be your real estate resource, I'm super excited to bring to you this Monday market update. Okay, I'm gonna do things a little bit different this time. I actually wanna call it the mid-year market update. That's because I got some fantastic stats from my office last week that I'm excited to share. So let's go ahead and start with the basics real fast. All right, so there are two types of markets within real estate. There is a seller's market. Seller's market is pretty basic. A seller's market is when there are not enough homes on the market right now to compete with the amount of pre-qualified buyers that we have. All right, and then we have a buyer's market. All right, a buyer's market is kind of that in reverse. It means that we have more homes available than we have qualified buyers. Does anybody want to guess what market we're currently in? Cue the Jeopardy music. Don't want to wait? Okay, we're actually in a seller's market. Actually, we are in so much of a seller's market that I would say, and the reason that it is because a lot of people have decided not to place their home on the market right now for one reason or another. Before we were in all of the shelter in place and all of the pandemic scare, we definitely already had a housing shortage, and we've continued to have that same housing shortage even after we're starting to see things open back up, which I completely understand. As a company, we went through and started some fantastic safety precautions to make sure that the sellers and the buyers were as comfortable as possible during all of this. And then we also offer a lot of virtual showings and virtual listing appointments to make that super easy. So if you're considering putting your home on the market, definitely give me a call, because this is a fantastic time to make sure that you make as much money as possible. All right, so since we are currently in a seller's market, let me tell you what's going on within Forney ISD. So last week alone, we had 219 homes total on the market. 31% of those homes are not available for a buyer to purchase. That means they're either under contract or they've already sold. All right, that's not leaving a ton of properties available. We actually had 44 total homes going under contract last week. Guys, that's insanity. That means we've got a lot of buyers out there. That means a lot of these houses are going at list price or above, and a lot of them are going with multiple offers. So that's kind of what's going on in our little bitty bubble of Forney ISD pre-existing homes. So what's going on all over the market? Well, some of the great stats that I got from my office, I'm just gonna go ahead and share some of those before. All right, so in January, we had a great housing market, great job market. Everything was going great. We thought the world was fantastic. So in January, the market was actually up 19%. But our market at Coldwell Banker Apex, we beat the market by over 39% because we were up by 59%. All right, and then February, the market was up by 9.6% from the year previously, but we as a company were up 37%, so we beat the market by 28%. All right, I'm sure you're probably thinking, yeah, Jennifer, but that was before, you know, all that's going on. Okay, so March, the market was still up in March. It was up by 2%. We beat the market though, and we were actually up by 22%. So that's fantastic. Okay, yes, we had shelter in place that happened at the end of March. So what happened in April to the housing market when none of us could really even leave our house? Okay, so overall, the market was down 19%. So I can see where that's concerning. But our company was up 5.6%. That's because we quickly shifted and quickly turned on some technology that allowed those that needed to move could still move. And then May, guys, the market was up. The market actually was down by 28% as a whole, but we were up by 7.5%. So we beat the market again, even in May, by 35%. Guys, June is going to be a record month. So just to kind of let you know, I think it's really important that you hire your neighborhood expert. You make sure that you hire somebody who's not only going to make sure that they know how to put a sign in the yard, put a lot box on, and put it in MLS, but also knows your market well enough to make sure you're priced, conditioned, and positioned correctly. All right, so what's going on kind of within my business? I can tell you my experience has been exactly those numbers that I just told you. I listed over 10 homes about in the last 30 days. As of those 30 days, 9 of which have gone under contract, most of which have already closed or are set to close here in the next few days. I had 7 homes that went under multiple offers, all of which are at or above list price. Excuse me, one house actually sold for $10,000 over what we listed it at. It's insanity. So that is what's going on. That is your mid-market update, guys. As always, if you have any real estate questions at all, if you are not in Forney ISD and want the same information but for your exact neighborhood, go ahead and don't worry about it. Message me. I'd absolutely love to help with anything that I can. As always, I am here to serve you guys in whatever that you need. So just go ahead and let me know how I can do so. Thank you guys so much, and we'll see you soon. Bye-bye.